Welcome to the FTA catch-up on Xreal Air 2 Pro Beam. I've spent some time with the Beam and wanted to share some interesting findings. The Beam. It's a device that allows you to use the Air 2 Pro glasses with some initially non-compatible devices and bring some elements of augmented reality to the Air 2 Pro glasses without having to use any device-specific app. This tech might be referred to with different names, but it's called Spatial Display by Xreal or Spatial Reality Display by Sony. In practice, what are the key differences between having the Beam with its spatial display tech and not having it? Without the Beam, you require a compatible device that you can directly connect via USB-C. If you don't have this device, it would simply not work. Once you have connected the device, the Xreal Air 2 Pro glasses will behave as an extra screen that will follow your head movements at all times. With the Beam. So, if you're using a Beam, there are quite a few differences. The first is that you can make use of the wireless feature of the Beam to aircast or play audio video from some Android phones to the glasses. Also, you can choose the size of the screen for any device. You can install some Android apps like VLC or some other video players. Interestingly, you don't need any other device to play videos, music, watch Netflix or Amazon Prime. It makes the Air 2 Pro and Beam combination completely standalone. And you can enjoy some of the AR elements via the spatial display. But what is the spatial display? The spatial display will offer three options. The first one is called Smooth Follow. The screen will follow your head movements, which is similar to the default behavior when using the glasses without the Beam. With the only difference that your head movements won't immediately cause the screen to move. There's a small delay that can help preventing dizziness. This is particularly ideal when using the glasses in a car, certainly as a passenger, on a bus, or any other place in which you can find a bumpy road or something that might cause sudden movements. Anchor. The display will be anchored or fixed to your body and not to your head. This could easily be one of the features that people might think of when thinking about augmented reality. This will allow having the display on a position so you can perform all the tasks and just watch the display when you look to a particular direction. The controls for this feature work really well and you can easily readjust where you wish the display to be located at. Sideview. This might be useful when working in front of a separate screen. It shrinks the display to any of the four corners in your field of vision. Depending on your particular use case, you might find it useful or not. I found it a bit too small to actually be useful. It was okay for video, but not for screens with text or graphs. My thinking around this was that if I'm watching a video with these glasses, I might rather watch it in full screen. But there are certainly other cases in which it might be okay to just have a shrunk display. Unexpected findings. I wasn't expecting the Beam to have a fan or get hot, but it does. After 30 minutes of usage, it reached around 34 degrees Celsius, but I saw up to 50 degrees Celsius after a few hours. The fan might be noisy enough to disturb people near you in a quiet environment, so be aware. While testing, either using the wire that came with the Beam or using its wireless feature, I noticed that there is some slight noise on the image, similar to white noise, as if there was some interference that causes this. The image looks clear, but not as stable as it does when not using the beam at all. Touching the temples on the Xreal Air 2 Pro to adjust the position or increasing the volume from the beam seems to cause some brief stuttering while playing a video. This reminded me of those movies like Robocop, Terminator, or video games in which you see things from the perspective of the robot and there's some sort of interference that briefly breaks the image on the screen. That's all for now. Thank you for reaching this point of the video, and I hope you find some of this information useful. See you later.